What's up, everybody? My name is Kat. I'm the Nerd of Strength, and today I'm going to be doing my predictions for Europe's Strongest Man 2022. We're back, baby, and I love to see it. The last couple of Europe's Strongest Man hasn't really felt like Europe's Strongest Man. While 2020 was a two-day event, the athletes list was definitely pared down, and last year, it just seemed like we couldn't get that many athletes. It was kind of in the middle of a very condensed Giants Live schedule. But this year feels like a truly big, grand Europe's Strongest Man, just like 2019. And of course, I don't mean any disrespects to Luke Richardson or Luke Stoltman. They both earned their titles. But I will say this year we have 5 different events, 2 new events for Giants Live, 12 athletes representing 11 countries. That's amazing and super diverse, and I'm very excited. We also, of course, have the Log Lift Challenge with Iron Beebe and Bobby Thompson. So I will talk about that in a bit. But before that, we are going to go over the athletes list and the events. First up, we have Kelvin de Ruyter of the Netherlands. He is the current SCL World Champion. Then we have Eithor Ingelsson Melsted of Iceland. Konstantine Janashia, who is making a return here, as he hasn't been here since 2019. Pavel Koryakov, who was the Open Men's winner at OSG 2021. Oleksii Novikov, who was, of course, our 2020 World's Strongest Man. Pat O'Dwyer, 5-time Ireland's Strongest Man. Ivar Schmokstelis, the 2019 SCL World Champion. Luke Stoltman, the current Europe's Strongest Man. Shane Flowers, a newcomer who actually ended up placing 4th at Britain's Strongest Man last month. Rhino Heinla from Estonia. I believe he hasn't been to Europe since 2015. Maurice Lalas, who placed 5th in last year's Europe's Strongest Man, who I'm actually disappointed is not the 30th athlete for Worlds. And finally, the Welsh Bull Gavin Bilton, 2-time UK Strongest Man. And for our events, we of course have the World Log Lift Challenge, aka the Max Log Lift for the 12 athletes. Then we have a new event for Giants Live, the Deadlift Ladder, the Carry and Drag, another new event for Giants Live, the Power Stairs, which I'm super excited for. Like, mid-2000s World Strongest Man, Power Stairs was my favorite event, so glad they brought it back. And finally, we have the Atlas Stones. So starting off with the Max Log Lift, we of course have 2 guest lifters, Iron Beebe and Bobby Thompson. They are both currently flying over to Leeds right now, so hopefully their flights get there safe and sound and no one's going to miss the event. I'm just going to say off the bat, give Beebe his first place trophy. I think he got first in the World Log Lift Challenge like, what, 5 times now? Bobby could probably give him a good run for his money, but do I think any records going to be broken on Saturday? Respectfully, no. I haven't seen a lot of training from Beebe lately, and I don't think he's going to hit 230 on Saturday, but that's whatever. And same with Bobby. Bobby's probably beat up from the Arnold Schoenemann Classic, plus he has Worlds coming up in a couple of months, so while his training is on point, do I think he's going to break world record? No, but I would love to see him add to his own American log lift record. Hopefully he can hit something like 220 and get his name up there. As for the guys actually competing in Europe, I think Luke is going to get top points in this event. Last year, he ended up tying with Oleksii and Graham Hicks at 195, and he didn't have to go too hard on the event because he, of course, said the title of Europe was more important to him than winning the Log Lift Challenge and getting the world record. He, of course, is going to have the same mindset on Saturday. He wants to keep his title. He wants to be a 2-time Europe's Strongest Man. Other guys to look out for on the log would be Oleksii Novikov and Konstantine Janashia. Janashia has a pretty decent log and can definitely get up there on the points. Oleksii, like I said, last year he hit 195, but because of the situation in Ukraine, I'm not sure how his training has been. He, of course, has been more trained to be on the front lines in the battle for Ukraine, and that's completely and totally understandable. So, super curious to see how he does on Saturday, but you know he's going to push himself to the limit. I mean, how great would it be if he actually ended up winning Europe's Strongest Man and bringing that title back home? But I digress. Next event we have is the new event for Giants Live. We have the Deadlift Ladder. This is typically seen at probably your regionals or local shows, but also the official Strongman Games. This is not only a power event, but definitely a speed event as well. Guys who have bad grip and need to use straps will definitely lose valuable seconds getting adjusted to the bar. So guys like Ronald Heinle will definitely lose some valuable points here. Another guy who will lose valuable points here is Luke Stoltman. Of course, deadlift is not his thing, but he's not going to come dead last. Unfortunately, guys like Calvin De Reuter and maybe Ivar Schmoxelis aren't the best deadlifters in this group. However, Konstantine Janashia could put up some scary numbers at a scary time on the deadlift ladder, so excited to see what he can do. Another guy I'm excited to see is Pavel Koryakov. Outside of OSG 2021, if you're looking for something, a competition that he was in, check out Ukraine Strongest Man 2020, where he actually beat Oleksii Novikov to win that title. Gavin's been training his deadlift super hard. I really hope his health is in order this year and looking for a return of the Welsh Bowl. Next up, we have a carry and drag, which of course is going to favor the heavier athletes. So guys like Janashia, Gavin, Luke, and surprisingly Kelvin will be really good at this event. Kelvin De Reuter is the Royal Truck Pull Champion, so he's really good on his feet and moving events, so he could definitely get in the points there on that one. Lalas will do decent at this, and I'm curious to see how Ronald will do. Again, grip might affect him. And Ithor and Ivars are guys who could definitely sneak mid-pack, steal some valuable points. Those two guys are my wild card for this event. Unfortunately, I don't know a lot about Shane Flower, so I do apologize about that. And then the next event we have is the Power Stairs. Again, super excited to see this one back. A lot of guys have been oddly training this one by just using a duck walk implement on top of a bench. Obviously, not everybody has the implement, you know, the actual stairs. So a lot of guys are practicing getting the weight up there, but not the hop and not the transition. So curious to see how that plays in on Saturday. I've seen Luke do it. So, and I've seen Konstantine do it as well. So again, super curious to see how that plays a part. For this event, I'm actually going to say Gavin's going to do really well in this event. They do it a lot in Ultimate Strongman, so he has a lot of experience with this. A guy who I think will be really good at this is Oleksii, Ithor, and Ivars. Ivars is another guy who has a lot of experience doing power stairs as they do it in SCL. And unfortunately, Lalas will probably lose points in this because height is not on his side, just like his brother. I'm sorry. Gets 2012 flashbacks. Anyway, and last up, we have the Atlas Stones, which, because the season is more spread out this year, we are using the heavier sets of stones, so it won't just be a total mogging of everybody doing stones in sub 20 seconds. So these guys are going to have to fight for those points on the final event. And honestly, looking at this group of guys, there's not a bad stone lifter here. Seriously, Pa, Ivars, Janashia, Luke, they all are amazing at stone. So super curious to see the times on that. It's going to be a tough one to call, but let's just say Ivars wins the Atlas Stones for fun. outside of my ramblings, who do I think is going to be top three? I'm going to say Janashia wins it. Well, he'll lose points on the log lift. Every other event is amazing for him. He has the power, he has the speed, and he has the mass for it. And he's come back strong and he's healthy. I think he actually can get the W on this one. He placed second at Europe's in 2019. We can get him to first place this year. Second, it is a toss-up between Luke and Oleksii for me. Now, emotionally, I want Novikov to win. Do I think he's going to win? No, but I want to see him on the podium. Absolutely. Depending on what his training is like, he can either get second or third, because he's probably beat up and tired from everything that's going on in his home country. So I'm going to say Luke second, Oleksii third. I'm going to say Luke in second solely because of the points that he'll get from the log lift, but also the Atlas Stones. I see Luke beating Novikov on the Atlas Stones. Fourth and fifth place, toss-up. And my toss-up is going to be between three guys: Ithor, Ivars, and Marius. Unfortunately, I think Ronald's going to drop points, probably end up sub like 6th or 7th, unfortunately, just because of his grip issues. which I really hate to say. Also, he's probably going to lose big points on the log, too. So, more versatile, explosive guys like those three could probably get in there and get fourth or fifth. Fourth place, you know what? I'm going to say Marius. You know, I'm probably thinking with my emotions because I'm still salted that he wasn't the 30th athlete for Worlds. Nothing against Nesman Amoskovich, of course. But he got fifth last year. Let's do one better. I say Marius fourth, Ivar's fifth, Ithor sixth, Rhino seventh. That's what I'm going to go with. Super curious to see what happens on Saturday. So there you have it. Those have been my predictions for Europe's Strongest Man 2022. And like I said, awesome roster of athletes, very diverse, and cool new events for Giants Live. If the rumors are true, some of these events might show up at Worlds, so super excited to see that. I definitely hope the powers there show up to Worlds. But again, very excited for Saturday. If you would like to watch this live stream, you can watch it on either Facebook or at officialstrawman.com. No, these are not free live streams, these are paid live streams. And even if you don't watch it live, you can watch it back later in the day or whenever you have free time. The next shows after this, I believe we have a couple of Arnold's qualifiers. South Africa and South America, I believe. Don't know the rosters for that. We'll see what happens in the next couple of weeks and maybe I'll do a video on those. Outside of Europe, the next really big show is World's Strongest Man in May. And we'll be doing a lot of videos leading up to that. Once again, guys, my name is Kai. I've been the Nerd of Strength. If you like what I do, please like, share, comment, and subscribe. And remember to stay strong and have a great day.